Interviewing people or making presentations remotely became commonplace when the coronavirus pandemic hit. I'm here to show you how to set up a remote interview or presentation to achieve the best results, all with some common household items. The concept is to set up the interviewer on Zoom, FaceTime, or whatever video conferencing software you prefer on your laptop, and then record the interviewee, that would be me, on your smartphone so that you get the best video quality. Here's the setup. As with real estate, the most important thing begins with location. Pick a spot where you'll be lit by soft window light. Soft window light works best if there are several windows all around you, especially if one is a little brighter than the other, and you face into the light. Pay attention to the background.
Don't have a bright window behind you, unless you're in the witness protection program. A great background has some depth and color, but it shouldn't be cluttered.
Choose a quiet environment or a quiet time of day. So let's start with the setup itself. We start with audio because sound is half the picture. It's really important. And the key to good sound is to get the microphone as close to your mouth as possible. Use your wired earbuds that have a microphone, like here. AirPods and other wireless earbuds probably won't work. If you have to, use an adapter. That would be if your phone doesn't have an audio plug. The best place for mic is right above your sternum, right about here. Wearing something with buttons makes mic placement a lot easier. Now, there are many different ways to run a mic cable, but the easiest I found is taping it inside the garment, especially if you do it around a button. Don't bury the mic under layers of cloth. And if your mic has a little hole on it, make sure that that hole faces out. That's the actual microphone. By the way, use soft tape, which doesn't crinkle like many of the clear tapes do. And stay away from jingly pendants or other noisy jewelry, including bracelets that can bang against a table. Next, we'll take a big rubber band and put it around the laptop screen. Then we take two paper clips and bend them like this. These will become a platform for your smartphone. Use plastic covered clips so that they don't scratch the laptop screen. Put the smartphone on top of the paper clips with the camera in the top center part of the screen. We'll fine-tune it later. Hold the phone in place with another rubber band. Then take the computer and bring it up to the level of your eye with a box or books or a stack of anything that will bring it to your eye level. Camera of the phone should be at your eye level. And then plug in the audio. Fire up the video conferencing software of your choice. We're using Zoom. Expand it to full screen and position the phone so that the phone's camera covers a part of your interviewer's face. This will make for the best eye contact. When everyone's ready, start the phone's camera and switch it to video. Double-check the framing. Make sure your head is neither cut off nor too far down the frame. Check the lighting and the background. Then hit record and record your interview or presentation. For long recordings, stop and restart your phone camera every 15 minutes or so to keep the file size manageable. And that's all there is to it. Now you have a great recording of yourself. If you need advice on how to send the resulting file to a video editor like us, eImage, watch 1 minute longer. Video files are huge, so you can't just email them. My favorite way to send files smaller than 2 gigabytes for free is with WeTransfer. Here's how. go to WeTransfer.com, accept or deny their cookies, click send a file, and accept their terms of service. WeTransfer is really free for files under 2 GB. Click the big plus sign to add your files. Find the file or files you want to send. It's probably in your photo library. Once you choose them, click Done to return to WeTransfer. Then click Next, accept the default send an email, and click Next again. Put in the requested email addresses and click Transfer. WeTransfer will verify your email address by sending you a number code. Just follow their instructions and then your transfer is on its way. Your recipient gets an automatic notice with a download link, and you get a notice when the recipient downloads your file. Making you look good is what a professional video production company like eImage does. But when we can't be there and you're on your own, this method produces excellent results. Happy recording.